Padlet is a really good tool for presenting different items on the screen at the same time. It's like a giant pinboard or notice board, and you can use it for a variety of ways. First of all, you need to sign up to Padlet for an account. Now, obviously, this is a third-party service, so you'll need to make sure that you're familiar with the terms and conditions of use and that you agree to their privacy policy. There is no obligation to use this service. It's just an option for you if you wish to use it to create a visualization of your resources. I've already got an account, so I'm now logged in, and I'm just going to make a new Padlet. So you get prompts to follow when you create a new Padlet. I'm not going to call my Padlet my Luminous Padlet. I'm going to call it my Example Padlet, and just change the title there. And you can see that changes at the top of the screen. My description, to help people use Padlet. So also with this pane, you've got a few options in terms of the layout. So you can have a freeform layout, which means that you can stick things wherever you like, and that can be quite useful if you're not quite sure how you're going to cluster your objects together. You might also want to use a grid or a stream layout, but I'm going to start first of all with a freeform layout. You can choose a wallpaper, which is the background for your Padlet. If you click on the More link, you'll get access to some more options here. And I'm just going to choose quite a dull background at the moment, this blueprint look and feel. You've got some more options down the bottom here, but to be honest, you don't really need to use those. If you want to create a web address for your Padlet that is based upon particular keywords, this might make it more searchable. You can do that, but if you're just doing it for your own purposes, you can leave the web address as it is. So I'm going to click Next at the top. I then also want to check who's got access to this Padlet. So you can either make it private, i.e. that only you have access, password protected, secret, which means that anyone with the web address can access the Padlet, or public, which means that anyone can search for this Padlet. They'll find it in search engines, they'll find it in the Padlet database. Now I'm going to choose secret because I don't want people to find this and stumble across it, but I do want people to be able to access it when I provide them with the URL. I also want to make sure that only I can change the Padlet. You can use this, and I have done this myself, where you create a Padlet and allow anyone to add things to it. But I don't want that for this. This is a curation of my resources and my stuff. So I'm going to change those with access from can write to can read. And if you have any other people that are contributors, you can add their email that they've registered with Padlet or their username from Padlet onto this area, and then they can help you create this resource. I'm going to disable the remake option. I don't want people to take my Padlet and do other things with it, just because I'm going to be using this to create my resources. Then click Next again, and now I can start posting. So how do you post to a Padlet? It's very easy. You can double click on the Padlet area, and then you can either do a text-based post, and you can put in a title and some text, and you can just drag that anywhere you want. So you can add as many of these little post-it notes as you like, cluster them together, move them around. It's quite an easy tool to use just to curate a lot of post-it notes. So I'm just going to put those together. You can also click on the little plus icon, and that will allow you to create an item as well if you can't double click. As well as text items, you can also use attachments. So let's start first of all by adding a YouTube video. I'm going to add a YouTube video from the web. So in my YouTube collection, I have a URL of the video already, and that's just the web address for the video on YouTube, and click submit. And this video is not a very exciting video, it's about how you set up your audio for Skype, but that's one of mine, and I'm going to click OK, and now that's dropped in as a thumbnail onto the Padlet. So if I don't put in a title and any other text, it will just link to the video there and have the title of the video below it. But if I wanted to edit that, then I can hover over and I can click the edit icon, and I can add in a title if I wanted to, and it will appear like this. So you can see here we've actually got a thumbnail, a very small version of the video, and you can zoom into that or you can play it in the post-it note format instead. That's how to add videos. Let's add something else. So I'm going to add this time a photo. So you can actually upload photos. So I'm actually just going to choose a file from my desktop. That can take a little while to load, particularly if it's a large file. and then click OK, and here I have a little thumbnail of my photo. You can expand and make these thumbnails smaller or bigger just by hovering over the corner of the post-it note. And the same thing really with the video too. I can also add links to files and websites, so let's just add a link to Google there. There we go, and obviously that's Google. And if we clicked on that now, that would take us to the Google webpage. So you can add on links to web pages as well. So it's quite versatile. You can use this on a tablet as well. The controls are slightly different on a tablet because you need to use the touchscreen, but it will allow you to create these resources, and you can make quite good-looking pages with links that people can click on, and you can contextualize these pieces of content with the text-based post-it notes as well. When you're ready to share that with someone, there's a share link at the very top. And if you click on the Share Export Embed, you can copy the link to the Padlet, and that will go to your clipboard. You can embed the Padlet if you're using a blog, or you can email it, share on Facebook, or share on Twitter. If you need to save this, you can save the entire Padlet as an image. So I'm just going to do that now, just to show you what it looks like. And what that does, it takes your entire Padlet landscape and tries to present that as an image. In this case, it doesn't quite work out here for this one. It doesn't quite show me exactly what I've got on screen. Another option is to save as PDF. And if you export as a PDF, you get the content, all the titles of the post-its that you've put on there, but you don't necessarily get the links to the resources. So here we've got no link to the video, it's just the thumbnail, got no link to the website, it's just a logo that appeared. So you do miss out on the link ability of Padlet here, but it does take you to the proper Padlet at the bottom, which will then obviously take you to the links of the stuff that you've created. So, very good tool for bringing things together, presenting them on a web page that people can explore and click on, but not so good in terms of exporting out.